A Kimmy Pace.
Oh my god, I want to do the Owen Wilson wow, but alien version. Ready?
Wow.
Today, I mean, I feel like you clearly know where we're heading. We're heading to space, but we're gonna take some lovely cider with us and talk all things aliens today. Well, we have a little beverage and I get ready literally for outer space. So if you guys wanna see how I pulled this look together, if you want some space cadet costume inspo, or if you just wanna crack a cider with me and hang out tonight, then just keep watching. We have to break out the trusted Bentley ears. Outer Galaxies with Coachella, that's kind of the vibe I'm going for, you know? Just gonna do my normal makeup, which I won't give you guys the talk through of because I feel like you've seen this a few times and this rarely ever changes much. Also, you know, while we're at it, I'm gonna crack open a good old cider just to get ourselves in the autumn mood. You know, cinnamon apples, all of that good stuff. Also, this is the only drink I have left in my fridge right now, and I figured that I should have my last drink in this apartment with you guys. To spiked apple juice. Also, the fact that this is Queen Street cider makes me a little bit sad, I'm not gonna lie. So I have a question for the audience, everyone involved, everybody listening today. Do you or do you not believe in aliens? Leave me a comment down below. This is one of those questions that I feel like is one of my favorites to ask people because I feel like I can know instantly how well I'll get along with somebody based on their answer on if or if not they believe in aliens. You really just get a taste for where how someone's brain can conceptualize life and the universe, which is a hard and a big thing to kind of conceptualize, you know? So I do believe in aliens. I feel like life is more fun believing in aliens, you know? And I really feel like you can't go wrong either way, whether you believe or you don't believe. There's that quote, I forget who said it, but it's a quote along the lines of, it's either that we're not alone in this universe or we are, and both outcomes or both truths would be equally terrifying. And that's kind of true because I feel like if you think about the fact that how big the universe is, like we are just, our solar system, let alone our planet, is not even like a grain of salt in the vastness of the universe. So, and our solar system, like we aren't even a grain of salt in our galaxy. Like we're one galaxy of billions, if not trillions, I believe, of galaxies, which is crazy if you think that we would be the only intelligent life form or form of life that we know of, especially if you think about the thought of them possibly being further advanced than us, possibly having been to Earth before. I don't know if you guys have ever watched alien documentaries, but there's a lot of common details within a lot of different stories of people who have never met each other or knew of each other. And I have tripped and fallen down many of alien documentaries shamelessly. I think that's why I would say I do believe in aliens, because I find it way less likely to believe, given how vast and giant our universe is, that we are the only intelligent living species, if not just living species. But then again, I've dipped into Stephen Hawking's A Brief Answers to Life's Big Questions, and the way that, and it's a little above my head, I'm not gonna lie, but there's parts of it that I can kind of grasp what he's trying to explain in terms of the idea of time, gravity, and space in general. So it's even kind of crazy when you think about different dimensions in which this dimension of the universe, we could be the only living life form, but there could be other dimensions of the universe of different life forms, including our own life in different, like it's just, it's so, when you really start to think outside the box like this, there's just so many, it's like a kaleidoscope of possibilities. I need a sip. There's just no way. I'm gonna put my foot down and I think there would be aliens. I think we're aliens, honestly. I have this theory. I am probably gonna get butchered by anybody who has possibly gone to school and knows much more than me, but there's this theory I have. It's definitely likely not the most intelligent theory, but I also haven't found anybody that can't agree that it is a theory that gets you thinking. So there's so much of human history that is kind of hearsay in the sense that yes, science has taught us a lot, but science can only really go so far. And a lot of science is really based off of speculation and then finding any kind of details to fit the proof needed to prove that speculation, right? Not all science, clearly there's a lot of science out there that has been proven, but I think when we get into way like prehistorically before humans were documenting things, like before the first cave writings and things like that, I mean, human evolution, I don't know a whole lot. I probably should before I say what I'm gonna say. I have this theory that so I read this book called Sex at Dawn, and we are equally as related to chimpanzees as we are to bonobos, which is just a different type of monkey, which also, by the way, have sex for pleasure, not for dominance, are very peaceful creatures rather than chimpanzees, which tend to be very violent creatures. It was basically just this whole idea that humans are innately actually peaceful beings that enjoy sex, not violent beings that run off of male dominance and power. But anyways, that's totally besides the point. When I was reading this book and listening to just even how small in relation in terms of our DNA we are to these monkeys, like I think it's 49%, I could be totally wrong, I read this a really long time ago, but you know, like it wasn't like we were 80% monkey, we were like less than 50%, I'm pretty sure. And it got me thinking, like, where are all of the, why are monkeys still here? Like chimps and bonobos are still here and humans are still here, but where are the cavemen and where are all of the stages in between? Why, like how did we just continue to evolve but monkeys just didn't and they just stayed where they are? I feel like anyway, fuck it. I'm just gonna keep going. And then that got me thinking, you know, what's the difference between monkeys and humans? And arguably, I think chimps are incredibly intelligent, but I would say it is our intelligence. It's our ability to speak in conversations. There's no denying that human beings are the most intelligent species on this planet, at least. So what if we're the aliens? What if intelligent life of some form came to Earth and basically mated us with monkeys, or mated their intelligence with monkeys to create humans? And then that gets you thinking about so many other things. For instance, there's this documentary I watched a really long time ago, but I found it really interesting because it was basically the idea that the reason why humans have webbed fingers and webbed toes is because we were once creatures that lived in water, which goes totally against the whole monkey theory, right? But then that got me thinking, like, if let's say my theory is correct, that intelligent forms came here to Earth, decided to just basically crossmate with different things to see what would perform best, it would have created this like combination of so many different species and so many different just like creatures, if you will. Like, and that's why there's also theories that mermaids were a real thing, like half fish, half human, or that they actually could be a real thing at the bottom of the ocean, because we know less about the bottom of the ocean than we literally do about the universe, fun fact, which is also crazy to wrap your head around. But yeah, it just got me wondering, like, what if we're actually half alien, half animal? And that's why we have so much duality between our minds and our bodies, and why we always want to just like escape up into our brains and our intelligence. And then like we suffer from things like anxiety and so many other, just like, we're so intelligent, but we're so vulnerable to life because we're in our human bodies, you know? Oh, I don't know, I'm going out there, guys. I feel very unfiltered right now because these are the things I wonder about in my actual day-to-day life. And then I'm always like too afraid to bring them to the internet because I guess I should, you know what? That's a very fixed mindset thing of me to say. If any of you guys do know any knowledge on this, please let me know. Allow me to grow in my education of said theory. But anyway. So recently got released that apparently the White House or the Pentagon or somebody proven documentation of being visited by something or other. And I always get really skeptical of that stuff. I think sometimes things get released very strategically to distract us. And I'm like, what are we supposed to actually be looking at? Because if you're telling us that aliens came to us, you're telling us in the year of 2020, probably like the worst time to be telling us ever. That's like, that just screams distraction to me. But it doesn't deny the fact that information was released. So again, especially if you're someone that doesn't believe in aliens, what do you think about that fact? What do you think about that knowledge, that, or just even that release? piece. I have a couple friends that think it's a distraction, and I have a couple friends that think it's like legit, that it's just time that people know the truth type of thing. I don't know. There's got to be some validation to that, right? I don't know. So like, is there more than one? Are there different types? Have we been contacted many times? Are they time travelers? Because when you start to get into space travel, you inevitably have to get into time travel, because unless these aliens can last or live, I don't even know what they would need to live. Like, maybe they wouldn't even need oxygen. Maybe they don't age like we do, but like, you would have to be able to live hundreds of millions of years in order to travel to Earth, you know? Unless, again, that's why you have to think about time travel, because unless they were able to break themselves down atom by atom, defy space, time, and gravity, travel across space, and reform here on Earth, which isn't like far-fetched when you think about things like radio waves, or if I were to send you a text message, that text message would be broken down into bits of information sent to a satellite, which is then sent to your cell phone, and the bits of information reform themselves into a text message. So you kind of have to think of time travel in that sense, because they would be crossing hundreds of millions of years at one time, which would be hundreds of millions of years for us. So it's also like, did they actually leave their house when dinosaurs were still here and then make it here? And like, I think the documentation was from like 2004, 2006, just to be like, hey, what's up? And they came at a good time, let's just say that. If you're an alien and you're watching this and you were here in 2006 and 2004 and you can time travel, don't skip forward just yet. We aren't sure of the outcome. Maybe just go right to 2024, 2026. So I just got this grand idea of turning my lips blue, since that's the color my hair is gonna be. This could either turn out or not. So this is lip glue that I'm using, and I've been using it for my sparkles as well. I haven't actually tried it on my lips yet, so this might feel really weird. Also, I need a mirror. This tube literally reminds me of lip gloss in 2004. So I'm now gonna take blue eyeshadow and just literally go over top of that glue. Turning point every time I do any get ready with me's. And this is also why I don't call them makeup tutorials, because I feel like it's like I'm literally making this up as I go, and this could always turn into a failure. Oh, this is gonna be weird. This is gonna be really weird. How do you drink cider with glue on your lips? It actually looks like an alien's been drinking this. So another really fun theory I've thought about before is, you know how back in the day, like let's say during Shakespeare's time, the only possibility of real like creation in terms of longevity was to write a book or to write something or to create some sort of documentation of some type. Like for instance, we read Shakespeare because Shakespeare's books were left behind. Then you speed forward to our generation, and we're born during the era of digital creation. So while yes, we can still write physical books, we created this whole new vast place of documentation called the internet. I just got eyelash glue everywhere. Oh my god, oh my god, and I missed my cider. You need to see this. Anyway, as I was saying, I was thinking about how weird it'll be, like, you know how lately every time we sign off we've been saying love you to Proxima B and back, after that show and tell video where we watched Stephen Hawking talk about Proxima B. Imagine it's like, let's say we make it to Proxima B in the future because we have to, right? And the digital online internet still like lives in some sort of capsule, because I'm sure that they've evolved to something else, just like we evolved from books to landline to dial up to Wi-Fi. But there's this like capsule of the internet, you know? And just imagine if some crazy distant time in the future, someone's tapped into the Wi-Fi time capsule trying to be vintage. They fall across this like mid-20s, long gone old Canadian gal that used to make YouTube videos that's like, I love you all the way to Proxima B and back. And this girl lives on Proxima B, and she's like, I don't know why my brain thought about that the other day, but I don't know. I love thinking about these things. I love thinking about space. I love thinking about universes. I love thinking about multi-dimensions. And I love thinking about where the heck humans are gonna end up, if we end up, you know? I'm so, so curious. I wish this was a live stream, because I'm so curious to hear what your guys' thoughts on the whole matter is. Like, do you believe in aliens? What do you think about everything that we've talked about thus far in this chat? I'm going to use this lip glue again, and create dots all across my forehead. Quick glitter highlight. This is probably also why I'm breaking out. Yep, glitter's already going everywhere. So happy with this decision. All right, guys, will this look good? I really don't like these bangs. I want those circles to show. I feel like I'm ready to go, you know, travel space. And now I'm gonna do a fun little editing. I'm gonna get up, I'm gonna spin, you know, my clothes are just gonna magically reform as a space cadet. Also, I hope there's cider in space. So there you guys have it. That was my get ready with me for outer space and all of my thoughts on aliens. I really want to hear what you guys think. Let me know if my theory made sense to you at all. I added some space buns. Can't go to space without space buns. And aside from that, I love you guys all the way to Proxima B and back. And I will talk to all of you guys in the next YouTuber video. Wait, we didn't even clink to signify that this is done. Also, I love that there's literally blue on my cider. I just feel like I'm actually in space right now. And now I will talk to all of you guys in the next YouTuber video. Bye, guys.